Welcome to the presentation for the paper, The Impact of Negative Relevance Judgments on NDCG. This paper is joint work by Lukas Gienep, Mike Fröbe, Matthias Hagen and Martin Potthast. NDCG is an IR evaluation measure, is commonly assumed to produce scores between 0 and 1. This, however, is only true if the relevance levels used to calculate NDCG are positive. But herein lies a problem. Negative keywords are prevalent. They are commonly used at track and other shared tasks to mark spam, inappropriate documents, or otherwise irrelevant content. As you can see in the table to the right, negative keywords appear at about the same rate as key documents, between 2 and 6%. Therefore, the impact negative relevance judgments have, or rather should have, on evaluation results cannot be neglected. On the other hand, boundedness to the 0-1 interval is necessary, since it ensures many statistical properties of NDCG. The question we address in this paper thus becomes, how can we handle negative gain values while keeping NDCG bounded to the 0-1 interval? We compare three strategies. First, the original NDCG formula calculated with negative scores. The apparent problem here is that this results in potential violations of the measure's bounds. The second strategy is to treat negative values as zero. This strategy is the current practice employed by many evaluation tools, such as TrackEval or TrackTools. While ensuring boundedness, this represents an information loss, as between 2 to 6% of the data is ignored. This data, however, is valuable and might impact evaluation results. As a third strategy, we propose a novel modification of the NDCG measure that adopts full min-max normalization. Here, not only the ideal, but also the worst possible ranking is incorporated. This ensures boundedness in all cases, while also including all available information. As a downside, the properties of this new measure are still unknown. Therefore, in the remainder of the paper, we provide more context to which of these three strategies performs most favorable in practice. First, we study the frequency and impact of boundedness violations that can occur. We address two questions based on data from the Track Web Tracks from 2010 to 2014. First, how often is boundedness violated? When calculating the worst possible scores for each topic, between 70 and 100% of topics might violate the boundedness property. Between 8 to 68% of topics may even score below minus 1, effectively doubling the range of possible NDCG scores. We thus can conclude that unboundedness is a widespread issue and needs to be addressed. The second question is, how do the two proposed solutions impact system rankings? The strategy of ignoring negative labels can affect the system rankings slightly, as indicated by a Pearson correlation coefficient of 0.89 compared to the original NDCG ranking. The min-max strategy, on the other hand, nearly perfectly reproduces the original rankings. Thus, the current practice of ignoring negative keywords seems unsuitable, while the novel approach is promising. For an in-depth comparison, we now compare these three strategies with regards to reliability, stability, and sensitivity of the measurements. For a detailed operationalization of these three properties, please refer to the paper. The reliability of a measure is its ability to reflect the actual performance differences of systems. This is calculated as the portion of the resulting measurements that can be attributed to actual differences in system effectiveness, as opposed to topics, annotation, or interaction effects. Showcased here are reliability scores for Track 2011 and Track 2012. Min-max is the most reliable strategy, followed by ignoring negative labels and original NDCG. Its unboundedness increases the measurement's variance for original strategy, which is detrimental to reliability. Secondly, Sensitivity is a measure's ability to successfully tell two systems apart at a certain significance level. Showcased below are sensitivity plots showing the accumulated proportion of system pairs separable at a given significance level. Throughout, ignoring negative keywords negatively impacts the sensitivity of the strategy. This is likely due to the implicit information loss, as min-max and original perform similar and better. Finally, the stability of a measure is its dependence on the number of topics, so how many topics are needed to reach a certain error rate for system evaluation. Here, min-max performs much better, likely because of the reduced cross-topic variance due to restricted interval. Even at higher topic counts, the other two strategies can't match this improved error rate. In conclusion, we identified a common problem in modern IR evaluation. The arguably justified use of negative relevance judgments can lead to a boundedness violation for NDCG. While many experiments opt to annotate negative labels, the current practice is to just ignore these for evaluation. This does not adequately address the problem. We propose an alternative solution, adopting full min-max normalization for NDCG. This restores boundedness while also preserving the system rankings. It also yields additional benefits with increased stability, reliability, and sensitivity. Thank you for your attention.